To use pivot tables in Excel, make sure the data have headers or titles, and there are no entirely empty columns or rows. Click somewhere on the data. Click Insert, then Pivot Table. The entire data will be automatically selected. Click OK. First, suppose I want a grouped frequency distribution for mileage. Then I'll drag mileage into the rows area here, and drag it again into the values area. Because mileage is quantitative, Excel automatically shows the sums. Since I'm interested in frequencies, I will right-click anywhere in the sum column and select Summarize Values by Count. Now I want to group the data into these class intervals. So I'll right-click anywhere in the row data and select Group. Since the lower limit for the first class in my distribution is 0, I'm going to be starting at 0. The ending at is going to adjust itself based on the class width I select. Since my class width is 10,000, I'm going to leave by at 10,000. And that's the frequency distribution table. Now, if I want relative frequency distribution instead, I can just right-click on any count value and show values as. I can use percent of grand total or percent of column totals since I have only one column. And that's the relative frequency distribution. I'm going to change it back to frequency. Now I want to display the frequency and relative frequency side by side. I'm going to drag mileage again into the values field. Then I'm going to right-click somewhere on the second one and show values as percent of column total. Next, suppose I want to see the mileage distribution of American cars only. Then I can drag origin into filters and then click on the drop down here and select American. And that shows the distribution for American cars only. I'm just going to uncheck origin here to remove it and also remove the second mileage field here. Suppose I now want to see the mileage distribution for all car types at the same time. Then I can just drag type into columns. I'm going to highlight the entire table, right click and center for better display. I can also click on the column drop down here and select only the car types I want. And I can show this as percent of grand total, as in a contingency table, or as percent of column total to reveal mileage distribution within each car type. Now I'm going to clear the areas by unchecking the fields here. Suppose I now want to know the percent of German cars that are convertibles. I can drag origin into rows and type into columns, and then drag any of them into values. That gives us this two-way table. Since I want percent of German cars, note that the keywords here are of German. Then I'll right-click somewhere in the table data and show values as percent of row totals, since German is in the rows. Note also that row totals are 100%. Therefore, the percent of German cars that are convertibles is 8.11%. Now, suppose I want the mean price of all SUVs sold. So I'm going to drag type into rows here and drag price into the values area. Since I want the mean price, I'm going to right-click on the value and summarize values by average. I can also set them to two decimal places by highlighting the values and pressing Ctrl+Shift+1. And these are the mean prices for the different car types. If I want the sample standard deviations instead, then I'll right-click Summarize Values by More Options. Select the sample standard deviation. Click OK. Now, suppose I want to find another measure like the median price for minivans, and median is not listed under More Options here. One thing I can do is to double-click on the minivan's value, and that will show me the table containing minivan data only. Then I can just type equals median, click E to select the entire column, and enter. And that's the median. And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.